Very important.
it's very important. Your chances, the odds are so much higher. And why do people, they used to do it with fax machines before that. I mean, the thing about it is, why do people want to hide behind emails and texting? What's the human explanation for this?
They have anxiety talking to people.
They don't have to say no in person. They can hide.
People hate to say no. Why do you think, that's a great point. Why do you think in the gut sales method, in the agenda, what's the best part of the agenda? What do I always tell people they can do?
Fire
Tell me
me.
no.
Fire me.
Fire me. Say no. Could you do me a, hey, Frank, could you do me a favor? Could you please fire me? You don't have to say you'll think about it or talk to your lovely better half or your five chihuahuas. Could you just say, Claude, get lost? It ain't gonna happen. Would you do me that small favor, please?
Just
I can
you
agree to
gave them
that.
permission that you're not going to pressure them.
Right. Why am I doing that?
Bring the
Why am I
walls down.
doing that? What's going on? What's the real reason for that?
Give
That's
them out.
crazy.
Because I use
It's
different
different.
sizes.
Is that a pattern interrupt? Is that changing the whole dynamic of traditional sales conversations when you say to people, just a small favor, Corey, would you please fire me? Could you do that for me at the end of this conversation? There's no pressure here. Let's do what's right for you. If this isn't right for your budget or your needs, or you just don't like my bad haircut, would you just say get lost, Claude?
Absolutely.
Oh, you're a gentleman. Thank you. What do you think he's ever heard that before from any salesperson? Life insurance, real estate, Porsches, anything?
No.
Hardly. What do you think is going on subconsciously in his mind when you say to somebody something like that? Well, what if I, hey, what if I want to say yes? Who's this guy to tell me to say no? Right? Are
This
you,
guy's different.
this guy is different. And what's
He
human
doesn't
nature?
need the sale.
He
He's
doesn't
not
need
desperate.
the sale. This guy is so busy, so successful. He doesn't really need the sale. He doesn't have to pressure me. Is that different from your competition? Your competition, will they ever do a pattern interrupt like that?
No.
No. How about phone calls when we do? Let's go through this. Feigning ignorance. Why am I calling? I don't know. Jessica, you got to mute yourself. Thank you. Got to mute yourself. Thank you. When we feign ignorance, when we just did a great role play with Corey or John or Frank, when you go to somebody, I don't know. Isn't it human nature just to jump all? What do you mean you don't know? You're the salesperson. You're supposed to have all these. Well, I don't know what you meant. I don't exactly. Are you? Doing feigning ignorance is one of the most powerful ways to gain control. You say, you're right, sir. I don't know what's going on. I'm so overwhelmed. There's so many people calling about this property and everything like that. Let me just, if it was available, you don't have somebody who's interested right now, do you? So we feign ignorance and then we go always answer a question with a, come on.
Question.
Question, why? Is the person who asked the question in control?
Yeah.
You better believe it. But if we're just cross-examining somebody, how do we feel when someone's just asking one more question, one more question? What is that? How do you feel about it? And you know you're not going to do business with them. They're just picking your brain for free all day long. How does that
Feels
make you feel?
disgusting, like I'm being used.
Yeah, you've got to turn around. Sir, hey, Brent, you can ask one more question, but can I ask one? Can I, before I do that, and I'll answer your next question, and then we really have to go. I've got three other people who are on hold right now. What do you need from me in order for us to make a commitment and move forward right now?
Oh, I just really need you to answer all these questions, Claude. I was
And if I
hoping.
answer all these questions to your personal satisfaction, you have enough money budgeted, you're the authority person, you're the person who can sign a contract today.
That's what I was telling you earlier before on question number 16.
Okay. I love the way you do business. So you have the money. You can put 25,000 today. Okay. And just another question. What the source of that money? Is it a bank transfer, a Visa card, or
It would be a home equity line of credit on my second ex-husband's house.
Oh, okay. And you've been pre-approved?
Oh, yeah. He keeps sending me money as much as I like.
Okay. So you could write a check on that HELOC and send it today.
Yeah, he could for sure.
No, he could. Oh, but you couldn't. So you got to listen.
No, but he'll do what I ask him to do. He's like a chihuahua.
Oh, okay. Okay. What does that tell you right away? That was a good role play.
Do
what
you want to do business with this lady?
Yeah. So you want to do business with him, and they're not in control of the money, are they?
No.
No. So this is, and what's the next thing they're going to say to you? Well, I have to call my partner. Oh, I couldn't reach him. I left voicemail. Oh, they're visiting. They're walking the chihuahuas right now. And then they ghost you, right? Yeah. Okay. How important is it to pre-qualify people?
As important as breathing.
It's huge. It's huge. How about when they jump all over you, when you say, I don't know, or you're acting ignorant, should you say an apology? Or no. When you're calling somebody up on a follow-up.
No, never apologize.
You know, say, oh, gee, I'm so sorry it took me so long to get back to you. If they don't know who you are, don't remember. Or it's even a cold call. And you say to somebody, John, Mr. Livingston, I am so sorry it took me so long to get back to you, sir.
Okay, that makes a lot more sense.
It works.
It really works. What do you think's going through his mind when you say, I'm sorry it took me so long? Maybe they went to your webpage for something for free. You had their phone number or email, and you say, I'm sorry it took so long to get back to you. Do you think that, how is that going to affect their behavior? Because they don't know who you are. They don't remember who you are. How do you think that's going to affect their behavior?
It gives them a scarcity mindset.
Yes. Yes. You've got a shot. How many people are rejected in the first couple seconds on a phone call?
A lot.
Why? What's the perception of a prospect when you call up and you sound like the typical dopey sales guy?
Sounds like
you're
begging.
I don't have time for you.
Not interested.
Yeah, they know already what you're... How many people don't answer the phone unless they see the caller ID and they recognize the person? I mean, you know, it's the biggest struggle in this world today. There's so much garbage. There's so much bad marketing out there that somebody who wants to personally contact somebody is thrown into that whole, pit of Calcutta there. Okay. With all the other bad marketers, it's hard. So we have to fight a little bit differently. Here's a good one. Here's a new one I'm doing. Let's see. Who else? I need another. Hey Randy. Mr. George. Can't hear you. You muted yourself.
Okay.
Hey, Mr. George, I know you're an expert on flooring and carpeting and construction. Can I get your opinion on something?
Absolutely, Claude. How can I help you today?
Tell me you don't love that opener. What happens when we go to another person? We're there to sell them something, but we ask their opinion.
Well, it makes it more of a warm call because now you've involved me, but you're asking, you're not asking for my money, you're asking for my expertise. So, you know, you're an opinion.
What's that do to you?
Everybody.